everyone, welcome to Magic TV. I'm Tristan Shaun Gregson, back here with Luis Scott-Vargas. We are, well, to us, on the eve of Grand Prix Dallas.
I mean, I'm figuring out what deck I want to play like today, even though it's like Tuesday when we're filming this. But yeah, we're looking forward to the Grand Prix. It's the first tournament I've played at in a couple months now.
I mean, you know, most people are keeping pretty close track of you, and you haven't been playing much Magic recently.
Well, I've been playing a lot of Magic. It's just not in actual tournaments. Like the Running of the Gauntlet series takes up a fair amount of my time, and I like it. It's actually just been testing for Dallas, so it's perfect. But yeah, we can kind of do a little roundup here. What decks look good going into Dallas? Kind of what I don't even mind talking about what I'm going to play because I don't know yet, but I could tell you what I'm considering first of all.
I mean, we could start at like the top of what you consider to be competitive, what's most likely, or we could start down near Vampires and kind of work our way back up.
The way I see it, here are the decks, like the best of the best, the tier one decks. Well, there's Stoneforge Mystic decks, so there's all the various flavors of Cobblade, you know, which kind of chicken do you want?
There's vanilla with blue, yeah. Vanilla with black and blue, like, all those
vanilla
kind of things.
Chicken doesn't sound very good. We've got Boros, which hasn't seen a lot of play lately, but I think is very good. And we've got Primeval Titan decks, which obviously just Balak.
That's the top right here.
Yeah. You've also got like Mono Red and Vampires, which I'm less sold on. I mean, they're decks, but I still don't really see why you would play. If you want to play a beatdown deck, play a Boros, play because it gets Stoneforge Mystic. I mean, it's still just insane. If you don't want to play Jace, then you can still play Boros or Primeval Titan. But Jace is less format defining than Stoneforge Mystic right now, and I think that's pretty clear. So I guess we could start with the one sticking out, which is the Valakut. Valakut still seems good. Everyone's aware of it. Everyone sideboards a bunch of cards to beat it, like mainly Flash Freeze, some Amora sides. I don't see a problem with playing Valakut. I'm not going to because I just don't like playing the deck, and you should not play a deck you don't like playing. But I would not fault anyone for playing it.
I think the real big question is with all of this Stoneforge action going on, all of this, you know, post-Paris, you know, got to be aware of the sword, got to be, you know, like there's these things out there to kind of stop it. What does the makeup of the deck look like now that would be different than what everyone's familiar with, if anything? Or is it just doing the same thing
Valakut,
it's always done?
You either pick Summoning Trap or Green Sun Zenith. You generally cannot play both. Right now, Summoning Trap looks better than Zenith because everyone's boarding in counterspells. Also, a lot of the lists are playing Inferno Titans, which seem pretty reasonable because they're like, you know, almost as good as Primeval Titan against all the Cobblade decks. And so having more Titans seems better than having stuff like Avenger, which is less good, especially as the black decks start playing Go for a Throat and Doomblade. There are a few ways you can build Valakut, but the Summoning Trap Inferno Titan deck seems like the best.
Those are kind of the two key cards you want to have.
I mean, you're already locked into like Primeval Titan, Overgrown Battlement, all those cards. So.
And then on the outside looking in, you've got cards like Gaea's Revenge, Wormcoil Engine, bigger threats like that may.
I'm less
do
thrilled
something
with all those, but you could try them. I haven't tested it extensively, so I don't want to, you know, advocate the entire 75. But those are the list with Titans, you know, eight Titans and Summoning Traps seem like the best to me.
Eight Titans is a big deal. Yeah. Because in the past, we like Jerry's list that
was a Titanic beating, if you will.
That won an event earlier in the year, only played like one or two, and maybe some Koths or something like that. But with all these little birds running around, all these little threats, it seems like
it's fireballing the entire board is pretty good.
I hope someone uses that soundbite or something somewhere.
Yeah. So moving on from Valakut, you've got all the flavors of Stoneforge decks. You've got straight blue-white. You've got blue-white black. Blue-white red is seeing less play because it just seems like the popular opinion that it's blue-white or blue-white black. I'm not sure which side of the fence I'm on. I don't like the mana in blue-white black, but Inquisition of Kozilek, which is essentially what you're splashing for, that and Creeping Tar Pit, is insane. So, I'm sure I won't know till Saturday which one's better if I decide to play that deck. So, I don't want to spend a ton of time on it. I think if you want to read about Cobblade, there are enough resources online to do so. Nothing incredibly new. I mean, just look at Jerry T's latest list. He's the one who's been playing it a lot.
It really just boils down to, do you want to let your mana base suffer in order to get sweet spells into your deck or not?
Yeah, I mean, that's basically exactly it. So, that's the choice you got to make. The other deck, which plays Stoneforge, which I like, is Boros. You've got, you know, four Stoneforge, four Squadron Hawk. You've got a lot of the same cards as these decks. But basically, instead of Preordain and Jace and Mana Leak, you've got Plate of Geopede, Goblin Guide, and Koth. It's, you're trading Preordain yourself for Preordain them with Goblin Guide. But, if you look at the Running the Gauntlet series, which I just did about with Boros, it was actually the best performing deck I played so far. I mean, I did the best overall in the week with it, and I was pretty impressed. So I think it's within the realm of possibility for me to run Boros this weekend.
I'm pretty excited about that. I mean, it seems like there's so many different four casting cost cards, I think is the best way to put it, that this deck can go with. You can go play either hero. It seems just fine.
Yeah, right now I've just got the max amount of Koths and no heroes. I just think Koth is more effective.
That's the other thing. It was the hero.
Especially since everyone's boarding in Condemn and Doomblade and stuff like that against Boros, Koth just seems way stronger. So that's where I am with that. There are some decks which I didn't mention. Rug is definitely still a deck, though I've been less enamored with it recently. I think if you want to play a Jace deck, the Stoneforge decks are a little better, just because I think Stoneforge is better than Lotus Cobra right now. And the Stoneforge deck's less dependent on Stoneforge as Rug is dependent on Lotus Cobra, because it's got so many expensive spells that without Cobra, it's really hard to cast them.
And the blue-white decks are playing Mortar Pod, you know, there's all these Inquisitions, all these cards going around to stop them.
Yeah, and you've got the resurgence of blue-black as showcased by GP Barcelona, but I still don't see it. I played blue-black, I tried it after the GP, and it still seems bad against the Stoneforge decks, so unless they're doing something, I'm doing something wrong, which is possible, I would actually stay away from that. So.
Well, I mean, I joke that you're kind of forced to play a card like Into the Royal now. Because you can't kill a sword. You kind of have to just buy enough time to.
And you can use your removal spells on the creatures, but still, I think blue-black is not a deck I would necessarily recommend unless you've been playing it a ton and are really familiar with it, which might be the case. But
kind of leaves control out in the cold right now in the current.
Yeah, Stoneforge is the best control deck. So, and it gets to be beat down too, which is why it's so good. Gets to attack both angles. So we've got some aggro decks. Like I said, mono red and vampires seem worse than Boros to me. I mean, I don't want to distill the standard deck into like three decks and say you've got no choice but to play these decks. But honestly, if you want to play a Jace deck, play blue white or blue white black. If you want to play a Stoneforge deck, play either that or Boros. And if you want to play a ramp deck, play Valakut. I mean, those are the decks which I would say are tier one. You can play blue white control, you can play rug, you can play vampires, you can play mono red. I'm not saying you won't be able to do well with these choices. But they just seem a little farther behind, like not a whole lot, but like they seem a step or two behind these other decks, and I just don't see why you'd go into a tournament with a deck that's less good, unless you really think you brewed up some sweet tech, which if you do, go win Dallas and you can definitely prove me wrong. I'm not saying I'm the ultimate arbiter.
The initial questions after that was like, are the Tezzeret variants dead? Like, was that a?
I tried Tezzeret. I tried some variations of it. Wasn't impressed. Like I said, right now, if you want what I'm considering to play in like a day or two, it's going to be a deck with Stoneforge Mystic, and it's either going to have Jace or Koth. So that's where I'm at. And
it's still more of a diverse answer than if Matt Nass had sat down next to me and talked about standard decks.
I don't think he's playing Elves. I think he's going to play a Stoneforge deck.
You know, Fauna Shaman in a Stoneforge Mystic?
Yeah, he might play that, but
sounds very reasonable.
There are Fauna Shaman decks, I guess. That's also true, but I mean, they're good against some of the versions of Cobblade, so I'll give them that. But I think Boros is still pretty favored against those decks.
Is it? I mean, they're still mostly like green-white quests?
Yeah, there's the green-white deck that Matt Sperling wrote about last week, which is actually pretty sweet. It's got, Fauna Shaman, Baneslayer, Stoneforge Mystic, Vengevine. And they're actually pretty good against the Cobblade decks. So I haven't tested with the deck or really against it, so I assume he's going to be playing it since he did pretty well with it last week. I guess we'll see where that goes.
It's actually a good opportunity to stop on, I was going to say, if Stoneforge is so dominant, where do you see the Divine Offerings or the Core Sanctifiers? But it seems like a lot of
choices.
That's
just not the way to attack them.
But I agree with you. I think a lot of people are playing kind of Baneslayer Angel to kind of.
Yeah, Baneslayer is a perfect way because Baneslayer stops all their sorted guys, so you just play Baneslayer and stop the party. But I think artifact removal is proving ineffective. It's just they have too many Stoneforges and swords. You're still getting two for one if you kill their sword that they got off a free guy. Like, it's just not good. So. That's where I'm at for Dallas. We'll see what ends up happening in a couple days. See if I was wrong or right or what have you. But sure. I would be surprised.
The people are what? They already know you won.
I'd be surprised if there were less than four Stoneforge decks in the top eight.
So 16 copies.
Yeah.
16 copies. That's, I think, it might be a conservative estimate, or you might be right on the money. I think going below 16 would be a bad idea. So.
Yeah. I mean, it very well could be like six copies. But I think four is the baseline, and I guess I would take either the over or the under. I guess I would take the over on 3.5.
Okay.
So we'll see how that turns out. Thanks for watching.